Then Bhante Kusala will address the gathering in English. Venerable members of the Mahasangha, dear Dharma friends, on this occasion we have all gathered to this Dharma hall in loving memory of Bhante Saranapala's sweet mother. And as her name implies, she is Deepti Rani Barua. So Deepti, like Venerable Naitahangulu mentioned, means luminous. So one of the Venerables mentioned that she must be in a luminous state of her mind if she is not attained Nibbana already. So what we are doing right now is seeing this very virtue of reciprocity. So what reciprocity means, mutual sharing. It is like when we love someone, we receive that love again, and there is reciprocity in that place. But when we don't receive that love, we suffer, we don't like it. But in terms of mother's love, no matter what, we do know that we receive our mother's love under any condition. If even we became a murderer in life, your mother would come to you and say, please be my son, even in my next lifetime. That is how unconditional her love is. So most of us here have not seen Venerable Bhante Saranapala's mother. But there are ways that we can know her and see her. How do we see Bhante Saranapala's mother when we can't see her physically? We can see Bhante Saranapala's qualities and look at Bhante Saranapala's mother's qualities the same way. So if we know that Bhante Saranapala is a wise, very kind, gentle person, we do know that Bhante Saranapala's mother is a very wise, very gentle and very kind person. That is how we see her. And when we see this mutual sharing that way, we are also able to think of our own mothers and their qualities. And in life, there are moments that you start to think, I wish my mom was here right now. When some good things happen, we suddenly start thinking of our parents, because we feel grateful that we are receiving, we are enjoying, we are happy for what our parents have given to us. And I think all of you are here also to show your gratitude, gratefulness for Bhante Saranapala's mother, for her great generosity of offering her own son to the sasana, to the Buddha's dispensation. So, in short, I would like to bring your attention to the Buddha's own mother. So there is one text in which we can see a conversation between the Buddha's mother and the Buddha. When, you know, Buddha's mother is one that of, you know, fed the Buddha during when the Buddha was a little son. But when the Buddha became a Buddha, she wanted to become a nun. And she was very old, but she still sacrificed her life and she dedicated to practice virtues under the Buddha. And also she became an arahant. She became fully awakened into the teachings that the Buddha taught. And she then came to a point that she no longer could live in this body. She wanted to pass away, and she realized that it was the time for her to pass away. On this occasion, she went to the Buddha to get the permission from the Buddha. Now that I have lived under your admonition for so many years, and it is time for me to let go of this body. And there is one beautiful that she's that thing that she said there. When you were little, now she's talking to the Buddha. She says, when you were little, I was feeding you on a cold plate, because the Buddha was a royal son. So she was feeding the little son in a gold plate. And while she was feeding the little son, she was also taking a little bit of that food. And she was putting that food into her own mouth. Now she's thinking about these subtle memories. And she says, if I knew that you were going to become a Buddha, I would have never done that. See how grateful she was. If I knew that you were going to become a Buddha, I would have never eaten from your plate. And at this moment, she says, she's reciting the gatha. She says, Aham Sugata Mata Te, Mother. So the Buddha is addressed like Sugata. She's saying, I am your mother, but I'd like to call you as my own father. The mother would never call her own son as her own father. But at this moment she says, I'd like to call you as my own father. Why she does that? Because in order to appease your thirsty of craving, I was breastfeeding you. But you have given me the Dhamma milk, for which I am forever grateful, she said. So that Dhamma milk is one that she received from the Buddha, which is why she was praising the Buddha as placing the Buddha in the place of her father. So on the moment of saying goodbye, she departed and the Buddha walked to the gate. And the Buddha returned back to the place where the Buddha was without turning backward in order to show how grateful the Buddha was to his own mother. So you are seeing that quality in Bhante Saranapala right now. It's not the time to keep explaining things. You have received admonitions in Sinhala. You also have received admonitions in English from the great Venerables. So at this very moment, just think about Bhante Saranapala's mother like your own mother and show that whatever the good that you have done in your life, including the good that you are doing today, may she be happy in whatever state she is, if she is able to receive our virtues, our happiness. And we all share very generously, like she shared with us. We all share very generously all the good that we have done in life in order to show that we are very, very grateful to her for offering this great son, Venerable Bhante Saranapala, to us. And just say thank you in your heart.
Thank you so much.